Mummy and Daddy, like, saw that when they held things in front of me, I didn't usually look up sometimes. And so that's how they realised seeing it, and that I couldn't see very well.
Retinoblastoma, so childhood eye cancer. So Ernie had tumours inside his eyes growing from the retina, so the back of the eye. So that's what the problem was, is.
Because in the beginning he was blind, and then they dealt with the cancer in one eye, I think, and then the other eye wasn't quite so lucky.
Because he's determined that if he can read and write small, then he becomes normal like everyone else, and then he can be a fighter pilot or a ship's captain, which is the kind of things he wants to do. Certainly not a case of wrapping up in cotton wool and going, oh, I'm a disabled child, can't do anything. It's more about enabling him, and if he can't do something, well, how can we change that?
I remember walking around the garden, speaking on the phone, sobbing, absolutely floods of tears. We've had enormous amounts of support in initially sorting out a statement. Ernie was at nursery school. I spoke to them right back then before he started nursery school to say, how do we sort out extra help for him? He's not going to cope even in a nursery class. You know, at the time he was recovering from chemotherapy, his vision was really limited. Spoke to Lorraine and she was brilliant at helping us how to navigate the system. And when we initially applied for the statement, we were told the things we wanted to be written in the statement couldn't be done. And Lorraine went, yeah, you can.
We liked planes because Daddy was around and he liked lots of planes, so we started liking planes, and it was a good thing because Daddy knew lots about planes.
I can see Ernie as a teenager maybe joining a climbing club and going away to the mountains and climbing outdoors with supportive friends, cracking on. Very proud of him, excited to see what he's going to do.